video cameras caught trucks arriving at the World Trade Center from about August 23rd until every night until about September 3rd. And the trucks were arriving at about 3 o'clock in the morning when everybody else had left the building, including the janitorial trucks. And the trucks were leaving at 5 a.m. right before the AAA personalities of Wall Street got to work to start their day. Something was brought into that building that would help with the detonation. There may have been work done on the detonation before. It may have been going on for months, but whatever they needed at the very end, they came and brought in that 10-day period. That's what we think happened. The airplane hijackings were a cover for the controlled demolition, which was undertaken by a small group of people, probably just 4 or 5 people. We are never going to know who they are, and it's not worth looking for them. And in August of 2001, I was told to stay out of New York City because the attack was considered imminent. We expected mass casualties and a possible miniature thermonuclear strike, bomb. However, I want to be very clear. The attack was always defined as airplane hijackings and a strike on the World Trade Center.
A shadow, it looked like a plane. Next thing we know, it was boom, the floor started shaking. And then we saw debris fall down, and next thing we know, we had to get out of the building. We stuck on the stairs for a while. We finally got down to the lobby. Then we get to the lobby, it was this big explosion.
All of a sudden, you just heard the loudest sound I've ever heard in my life. And got about 10 steps when I got blown across the lobby. And that's when I lost my tools, my Halligan and my axe.
We presume because of the initial explosion, there may have been secondary explosions as well that were detonated in the building by these terrorists. Robert Harper.
received a call that a small Cessna had hit the World Trade Center. And I was asked to go and man the Office of Emergency Management at the World Trade Center 7 on the 23rd floor. When we reached the 8th or the 6th floor, there was an explosion and the landing gave way. And I was left there hanging. I had to climb back up, and now I had to walk back up to the 8th floor.
Assistant Commissioner Stephen Gregory said, "I thought before number two came down that I saw low-level flashes. I saw a flash, flash, flash at the lower level of the building. You know, like when they demolish a building? Initially, it was just one flash. Then this flash just kept popping all the way around the building, and that building had started to explode." She said that while she was making her way downstairs, there were explosions going off everywhere. I was convinced that there were bombs planted all over the place, and someone was sitting at a control panel pushing detonator buttons. There was another explosion, and another. I didn't know where to run. Deputy Commissioner Thomas Fitzpatrick said, "It looked like sparkling around one specific layer of the building. My initial reaction was that this was exactly the way it looks when they show you these implosions on TV." A few witnesses spoke of horizontal ejections.
You want to call your mother?
The bomb in the building is quite clear enough. Sorry, you said the bomb?
What'd you say?
The bomb in the building start clearing out. Got it.
Big boom, come down the steps, everything fine till we got to the basement and everything just fell in. I got trapped in there with another guy, crawled out, kept getting hit in the head, had bags rolled around, finally we clawed our way out over the rubble.
Yeah.
Come on, Doc.
You did all right.
All right, way to be, Tom. Let's go.
Thank you.
I got hit initially with a blast of hot air, and I truly expected a fireball to be coming next. I expected to be incinerated in the street.
And conventional explosives like TNT, RDX, HMX, there's a tag, a chemical tag. So when the explosive goes off, the tag survives. Investigators can come and look and they say, oh, this has got some, you know, this tag in it. Tagant is the term they formally use. And now we can determine where this explosive was purchased and blah, we catch the guy. But with thermite, there are no tags. Very clever, very clever.
Isaac, for example, has more recently said, I know 9/11 was an inside job. The police know it's an inside job. And the firemen know it too. But you have not heard this on the nightly news.